In last few lectures of material testing and evaluation, we have discussed about various materials used for construction like cement, sand, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, bricks. Now, in this lecture, we are going to discuss the conventional material used for construction work called as timber. Myself, R.V. Chugdar, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering. Basically, timber is the conventionally used material for construction activities. Now, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the introduction of timber and sources of timber, advantages of timber, uses of timber in construction activities, market forms of timber in various types, veneers made up of timber, and plywood. Introduction to timber. Timber is another name for wood, whether steel standing in the form of trees or felled and turned into boards for construction activity. Timber is very common for engineering purposes as it is considered as an important structural material. There is a difference between wood and timber. Wood includes all types of wood, which may be burning wood, structural wood, furniture wood, etc. But wood suitable for use of structural material is called as timber. Means each and every wooden material is not called as timber, but if it is in a structural form for proper utilization of construction activities, then and then only it is called as timber. Advantages of using timber. Timber is easily available everywhere. Its salvage value is high. It can be easily transported by converting large pieces into smaller pieces. It can be easily joined and dismantled. Being light in weight, it is preferred for building works in earthquake-prone areas. From ancient days, the human being is using timber for construction activities. Since it is easily available and light in weight and can be easily installed and dismantled, this is very useful material for easy construction. Uses of timber. Timber is very much used for railway track sleepers. It can be used as members of roofing trusses. It is an important material for furniture making, or for furniture most commonly material used is timber. It is used as formwork for cement concrete structure, that is as temporary support system for formwork. It is used in case of packing and mostly made from soft timber. It is used for floors, ceiling and partition walls. These are some uses of timber. In first image, it shows the roofing system made by timber, that is rafter, purlins, vertical posts and the trusses. The second and third diagram shows the furniture made by using timbers for packaging purposes, for making sample safe. The wooden material or timber boxes are utilized, and for railway sleepers also timber is used very effectively. Defects in timber. Defects that usually occur in the timber may be classified into two categories. defects that develop during growth of tree and defects that develop after felling the trees. Some of the defects that develop during growth of tree are shown in following figure, that is hard shoes, star shoes. Then these defects after felling of trees, like bowing of timber, spring like structure after cutting of tree, cup formation, twisting of timber, honeycombing, splitting of timber. Preservation of timber. The methods that are commonly used for preservation of timber are chairing, tearing, painting, creosoting, Wolman salt, aqueous treatment, vacuum pressure process, hot and cold process, and seasoning of timber, which is most commonly used. Qualities of good timber. For effective use of timber in construction activities, we must know what are the good qualities of timber and how we can use timber effectively for construction activities. For that purpose, we must know the qualities of good timber. Following are the qualities of good timber. A good timber should be hard and durable. It should be capable of resisting the actions of fungi, chemicals, and physical agencies. The fibers of the timber should be straight and compact. Its freshly cut surface should smell sweet. Its weight should be heavy. Timber should be tough and should be capable of resisting shocks. It should be able to withstand the weathering effects. A clear ringing sound should be emitted by the timber when struck over each other. Heavy dull sound indicates decay in timber. It should offer adequate fire resistance and should be elastic in nature. There are various forms available in market made up of timber, such as battens, logs, balks, planks. The battens, these are small section of timber pieces. No cross-sectional dimension exceeds 5 cm in battens. Logs, trunk of trees left after removing all the branches is known as log. Balk, it is roughly squared sawn log. One of the cross-sectional dimension exceeds 5 cm while the other exceeds 20 cm. The next form is planks. It is timber pieces with parallel sides. Its thickness is always less than 5 cm and width always more than 5 cm. These type of components or forms of timber in form of plank are generally used for formwork and for scaffolding works. The next form is board. It is timber piece with parallel sides whose thickness is always less than 5 cm and width always more than 15 cm. The next form is deal. It is again a parallel sided piece whose thickness varies from 5 cm to 10 cm and width does not exceed 23 cm. Scantlings. These are timber pieces whose breadth and thickness are always more than 5 cm but their length is always more than 20 cm. The next form of timber used is pole. It is a log having its diameter not more than 20 cm and it is known as spar also. The next form of timber is veneers, which is generally used for furnishing work. Veneers are thin sheets of timber of very superior quality. They are obtained by rotating wooden logs of very high quality timber against a sharp knife of rotary cutter. Thickness of veneer may vary from 0.4 mm to as much as 6 mm or even more. It is peeled off from timbers like teak, rosewood, oak, mahogany, etc. The process of preparing a sheet of veneers is known as veneering. It may also include gluing of veneer sheets of superior quality over the base of wood of inferior quality. The next form is used for furnishing as well as for support of concrete is plywood. Ply means thin layer. Plywood is in form of boards prepared from thin layers of wood or veneers. Veneers in plywood are taken in odd numbers and then placed one above the other with the direction of grains of successive layers at right angles to each other. All veneers are held together by adhesive. The direction of grains at right angles in successive veneers increases the strength of plywood. The face of plywood with better finishing is known as face on and other exposed face as back of plywood. Plywood sheets are manufactured in size varying from 90 cm by 90 cm to 240 cm by 120 cm. Advantages of these forms of timber. They suffer little expansion or shrinkage due to variation in moisture content. They are light and are available in large sizes as compared to naturally made timber forms. They are available in decorative designs. They are not liable to split or crack. They make use of costly timbers in most economical manner. They are easy to work with and easy to install or dismantle by nailing or chiseling. Difference between veneer and plywood. Plywood is a type of manufactured wood panel. It is made by gluing together plywood layers, also called veneers. These veneers are glued together with adjacent plies having their wood grain at right angles to each other. Veneer, on the other hand, refers to thin slices of wood that are practically peeled off the wood. The slices are usually less than 3 mm or 1/8 inch thick. Fiber boards. Fiber boards are manufactured from wood or vegetable fibers. The pieces of wood, cane or other vegetable fibers are heated in hot water boiler. Due to boiling, wood fibers get separated. These fibers are put in vessel and steam it admitted in it under pressure. The steam pressure is then suddenly increased, which is then maintained for few seconds. In doing so, the natural additives contained in fibers are separated completely. The fibers are then taken out of vessel and cleaned off all superfluous germs. The fibers also obtained are spread on wire screen and forum of loose sheets and pressed. The resulting material is called as fiber board. These are rigid boards of thickness varying from 6 mm to as much as 25 mm. Their width is 1.2 meter and length is 3.5 meters. They are also known as presses wood or reconstructed wood. Generally, fiber boards are very useful for partition walls, for furniture works, for supporting freshly placed concrete as a formwork, and in scaffolding work also. Depending upon their form and composition, fiber boards are classified as insulating boards, medium hard boards, super hard boards and hard boards, and laminated boards. Uses of fiber boards for the construction of wall panels and suspended ceilings. Fiber boards are useful to construct partition walls as insulating materials against heat and sound, as tabletops and for flush doors. Since it is man-made material and it can be effectively used for soundproofing and for insulating material. Hardwood and softwood. Hardwood contrast with softwood. Hardwoods are not necessarily harder than softwoods. In both groups, there is an enormous variation in actual wood hardness, with the range in density in hardwoods completely including that of softwoods. Some hardwoods, for example balsa, are softer than most softwoods, while yew is an example of hard softwood. The next form of timber is impressed timber. Laminates, formica, sungloss, etc. are the examples of impressed timber. Impressed timber is nothing but timber fully or partly covered with resin. Impressed timbers are strong, durable, good looking and are not affected by moisture and weather conditions. They resist acidic effects and are electrically insulated. Properties of some important timbers. Babool. It is timber with strong, hard and tough properties. It is durable but difficult to work. It is having texture with quite strong nature. It is not available in large lengths. Its color is whitish red, which turns to red brown due to exposure of nature. It is used for construction of bullock carts, tool handles, well curbs and agricultural implements, etc. The next type is Deodar. It is compact, hard, durable and strong. It is yellow in color. It is easy to work with. It receives varnish very easily. It is used for railway sleepers, piles and other construction works, cheap furniture and railway carriages. The next type of timber is Sal. Its color is either light brown or yellow. It is hard, compact and heavy. It is durable and strong. It cannot be finely polished. Its seasoning is very slow. It cannot be used for decorative purpose because its surface cannot be finely finished. it is mostly used for tent pegs, doors and window frames, etc. The most commonly used type of timber is teak. It is used for shipbuilding, railway sleepers, furniture, railway carriages. It can be used for any structural and decorative purpose. It is a costly timber and hence used for costly and specified work. It can be easily seasoned and is easy to work with. It does not rap due to shrinkage and is fire resistant as compared to other timber elements. It is acidic in action resistant and also white and resistant. The next type is sheesam. It is used for furniture, plywood, sports goods, railway sleepers, etc. It is dark brown in color with golden and dark brown colored lining. It can be easily seasoned and receives high class polish. It is difficult to work with because it is very hard as compared to other timber types. Next types are any. It is yellowish brown and can be used underwater. It takes fine polish. Arjun. It is dark brown and heavy timber used for rafters, beams, etc. Next type is bamboo, used for scaffolding, thatches, roofs, etc. The next is mahogany, used for furniture, pattern making, cabinet work, etc. It is reddish brown in color. It contains resinous oil to save itself from insect attack. Next is mulberry. It is tough, elastic and strong. It takes clean finish and used for baskets, hockey sticks, sports and furnitures. Cambium layer. The bark on the outside of tree protects the living cambium layer that lies just underneath. It is the cambium layer that produces the growth ring inside the tree, adding few layers of phloem and xylem each season. The next form of timber, which is man-made material, called as MDF and HDF. MDF is medium density fiber and HDF is high density fiber. MDF is product of soft woods that are broken down by defibrator, added to wax and resins and formed from heat and pressure. MDF is sensitive to moisture. Whereas HDF is also a product of soft woods that are broken down by defibrator, added to wax and resins and formed from heat and pressure. But it is much more dense and made from exploded wood fibers. HDF is highly resistant to mold and infestation, and it is not sensitive to moisture. Endogenous and exogenous. Exogenous trees grow in width by forming a new layer of wood under the bark, and endogenous trees grow by forming new fibers within the trunk interspersed with old fibers. Now, in this lecture, we have discussed about various types of timber, various types of trees and their properties and uses of timber in construction activity. Thank you.